Good morning, children. I hope everybody is happy, fine by God's grace. Children, as we learned in the last week, celebration of being alive, we are going to learn the second part of this lesson in detail. Okay, I hope that you people have celebrated your life last week and you are all being happy to move on to the second part of this lesson. Okay, children. Children, I hope everybody is happy. I just want to quote something here. Blessed is this life and I am going to celebrate being alive. That is what Bernard has said in this lesson, the second part of the lesson. Already, children, we have learned the previous part of the lesson, how Bernard has been hospitalized and being in the hospital, and always he was talking about suffering, why this happened to both of them, his wife and Bernard. And later on, he is a famous heart specialist, and he was not able to complete his responsibilities, whatever is given for him, because he has been hospitalized. Now, in the second part of the lesson, Bernard has learned to live and celebrate his life by witnessing the two little boys. That is what we are going to learn from point number 7 till 13 points. Shall we move on to the lesson now, children? You can see here, in celebration of being alive, one morning several years ago, I witnessed what I call the Grand Prix of Cape Town's Red Cross Children's Hospital. It opened my eyes to the fact that I was missing something in all my thinking about suffering, something basic that was full of solace for me. See, here in this paragraph, Bernard is just telling that he has witnessed Grand Prix. That means what? He here, one of the several international motor racing events, okay, in Cape Town's Red Cross Children's Hospital. And he was missing something. All my thinking was about suffering. So that time, something basic that was full of solace for me. Solace means comforting and consolation in times of grief and sorrow. Grief means sorrow. So let us see what is happening in the next point of the lesson. See, what happened there that morning was that a nurse had left a breakfast trolley unattended, and very soon this trolley was commanded by an intrepid crew of two, a driver and a mechanic. The mechanic provided motor power by galloping along behind the trolley, which with his head down, while the driver, seated on the mower deck, held on which one hand and steered by scraping his foot on the floor. The choice of roles was easy because the mechanic was totally blind and the driver had only one arm. See, from this paragraph, what Bernard is trying to tell here is the breakfast trolley in the hospital, you can see, no, the nurses will be coming and serving the breakfast in the morning by using, you can see the trolley here with full of breakfast and whatever things, medicines, everything will be kept inside the trolley, and they will be pushing and coming to the patients, near the patient's bed, and they will be supplying the breakfast. So on that particular day, what is happening here? The breakfast trolley was unattended by the nurse. Only the trolley was left alone there with full of breakfast there. So immediately there were two little boys. They started to take up that trolley and started to distribute everything to the people who are there in the hospital. See, intrepid. Intrepid means bold and daring two children. Among these two children, what is happening there? One fellow was totally blind, and another one was having only one arm. Okay, this is what happening here in this paragraph. Shall we move on to the next para? See, they put on quite a show that day, judging by the laughter and shouts of encouragement from the rest of the patients. It was a much better entertainment that anything anyone puts on at the Indianapolis 500 car race. There was a grand final of scattered plates and silverware before the nurse and ward sister caught up with them, scolded them and put them back to bed. So what is happening here is these two boys started to run this trolley without the eyes and one was without the arm. They were so much happy and what is happening? They were full of laughter and joyfulness and happiness in the ward. And nobody started to feel about the suffering what they have in their own bed. So these boys, they were running like, see here the author is comparing with Indianapolis 500 car race. 500 car race, he is comparing these boys with this car race. And there was a grand final. Final means it was a climax and the turning point in the story. What these boys did, they were scattering the foods down everywhere and they were running and they were not bothered about that they are being blind or they were not having one arm. So suddenly what is happening? A nurse and a ward sister caught up with them. So both of them came to that particular place and they caught these two boys and they started to shout at these two boys and they made them to scolded them and they put them back to the bed. So these two boys went back to their bed. So let me tell you about these two boys. Children, about these two boys you are going to learn. These two boys who brought the turning point in Dr. Bernard's life. Shall we move on to them now? The mechanic was all of 7 years old. I told the boy, one who was blind, he was only 7 years old. One night when his mother and father were drunk, his mother threw a lantern at his father, missed, and the lantern broke over the child's head and shoulders. So he suffered severe third degree burn on the upper part of his body and lost both his eyes. So how he lost his eyesight? Because these parents were fighting at home and finally the lantern has been thrown on this boy's face and finally he lost both the eyes, has become blind. At the time of the grand prix, he was a walking horror with a disfigured. Disfigured, what does it mean? What is the meaning of disfigured here? Spoiled appearance. Okay. And face and long flap of skin hanging from the side of the neck to his body. As the wound healed around his neck, his lower jaw became gripped in a mass of fibrous tissues. The only way this little boy could open his mouth was to raise his head. When I stopped by to see him after the race, he said, "You know, we won," and he was laughing. See, what the author is trying to tell here is he was having a disfigured face that is spoiling the appearance. He was not having a good look of his face. Can you see the face here? And almost his long flap of skin hanging from the side of his neck. You can see this man here, a boy here. Okay. So, in spite of having disfigured face, this boy was so happy in handling this trolley and distributing the food to all the people in the hospital and making them very happy. He was not bothered about his eyesight. And what was his reply? Finally, he said that he has won the race by laughing and telling that he has won the race, what has been done in the hospital. Now listen here, the trolley's driver I knew better. A few years earlier, I had successfully closed a hole in his heart. The second boy, we are going to learn about the second boy. The first one is a blind fellow. The second one, it was a driver who just moving the trolley. He had returned to the hospital because he had a malignant tumor. See, already this boy was being there few years earlier and he was having a hole in his heart. The treatment was given for him and again he's been hospitalized for the malignant tumor of his bone. Malignant means year of diseases very harmful to life. Tumor here means diseases growth in some parts of the body. So it's a very dangerous disease what this boy was having. And a few days before the race, his shoulder and arm were amputated. Amputated means cut off by surgical operation. So many problems this boy was having, but without putting that suffering or the burden, he was not bothered about anything else. He was just moving the trolley very happily inside the hospital. There was a little hope of his recovery. He was not bothered about anything else. After the Grand Prix, he proudly informed me that the trolley's wheels were not properly oiled. Though he was having so many difficulties, he was having a hole in the heart, he was having a malignant tumor, and his shoulder arm were amputated. Without bothering about all the sufferings, this boy was just telling that the trolley's wheel were not properly oiled, but he was a good driver. He proved that he was a good driver in moving the trolley, and he had a full confidence in the mechanic. So he was not bothered about the sufferings what he had been so far. See, he has to bear so much pain, right? It's not an easy joke. Having malignant tumor and his shoulder and arm were amputated. With all his pain and agony, this boy was being still happy, and he's telling that I'm having a much confident in my life that I'm a good mechanic and I'm also a good driver. So both these two small boys, one who was blind, he was not bothered about that his eyes been totally blind, two eyes has been totally blind, and another one, he was not having one arm, he was not bothered about the sufferings and agony what he is going, but still these two boys entertained the people who are there in the hospital and made them very happy. On seeing this, Bernard was very shocked to see these two boys were not bothered about the suffering or pain, but still they wanted to celebrate their life. Now this was the turning point for Bernard. We'll see what is happening now. Suddenly I realized that these two children had given me a profound lesson. What do you mean by profound? Profound means a very great lesson these two boys taught Dr. Bernard in getting on with the business of living, because the business of living is joy in the real sense of the word, not just something for pleasure, amusement, recreation. The business of living is the celebration of being alive. You can see the title here. The title of the lesson is In Celebration of Being Alive. Now only Dr. Bernard has learnt a profound lesson in getting on with the business of living. And finally, he's telling that it is not something for pleasure, amusement or recreation. The business of living is the celebration of being alive. See, finally is concluding the lesson. I had been looking at suffering from the wrong end. He's realizing what through this boys. Okay, you don't become a better person because you are suffering, but you become a better person because you have experienced suffering. We can't appreciate light if we haven't known darkness. See, certain things Dr. Bernard is just telling here that you cannot tell that if you are not undergoing suffering, unless you undergo suffering, you can become a better person. That is the first point he is concluding the lesson. The second point, we can't appreciate light if we haven't known darkness. Suppose the current is off, what we are searching for? Light. Immediately we are going, taking up the torch lights. Then we are burning the candle, lightening the candle. So many things we are doing because we wanted to see the light. So what Bernard is telling here, one has to go through the sufferings of life. One has to go through the darkness of life. Then only he can see light. Nor can we appreciate warmth if we have never suffered cold. You cannot tell that unless you are suffering from cold, you will not know how we can appreciate warmth feeling, right? These children showed me that it is not what you have lost that is important. What is important is what you have left. So these two children have taught me that what you have lost. Always Bernard used to sit and murmur and think about his father, and he used to tell that, see, God is not there. Why this suffering has happened to me and my wife, and I have one child. Who will take care of the child? He used to tell everything else, and he doesn't like the children suffering in the hospital because he was a famous heart surgeon, and always he was telling that why God has given for suffering for us. But he stopped telling after seeing these two boys. What is he telling? These children showed me that it is not what you have lost that's important. What is important is what you have left. That is how Dr. Bernard concludes the lesson. I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. And what is the moral that you are learning from this lesson, children? See, Dr. Bernard then realized the true meaning of his father's words. He understood that it is the experience of suffering which makes one noble. One cannot enjoy life unless one experiences suffering. Therefore, instead of crying over what we have lost, we must be happy with what we have left. Okay, children, I hope you have understood the lesson. Children, go through your reader again and again and read the whole lesson. Take up your assignment test. Only 5 questions I have given. Please write the test and post it in the Google Classroom. Then do the Kahoots. Okay, on the very particular day itself, you have to finish it before 11 p.m. And children, go through the enrichment video which has been attached along with this lesson. I hope everybody is going to celebrate your life of being alive till we meet in the next class. Thank you, children.